you will see that the process for amending your constitution cannot be followed by the National Assembly. Then there's a process that has to be followed, which is critical. The writers of this constitution knew what they were doing when they said, look, if it's not for the National Assembly to start the agitation, the agitation to amend the constitution starts come from the people and will be supported by a majority of the states, for fifth of the states in the Federation, mode of altering provisions of the constitution. The National Assembly may, subject to the provision of this constitution, and alter any of the provision of this constitution. That is one. Two, an act of the National Assembly for the alteration of this constitution, not being an act to which section 1 of this constitution applies, shall not be passed in either House of the National Assembly unless the proposal is supported by the votes of not less than 2/3 majority of the members of the House and approved by the House of Assembly of not less than 2/3 of all the states. They are putting the cart before the horse. From these provisions, it would have been that 2/3 majority of the 30 set of the House of Assemblies would have come up with this thing and taken it to the House to be passed. Not for the National Assembly to pass and not send it to the state for ratification. That to me is like putting the cart before the horse.